think of E equals MC squared, we have this vision of Einstein as an old, wrinkly man with white hair.
E equals MC squared is not about an old Einstein. It's actually about a young, energetic, dynamic, even a sexy Einstein.
What would I see if I rode on a beam of light?
Perhaps some sort of electrical force is emanating outwards from the wire.
What?
Faraday, my dear boy, electricity flows through a wire, not sideways to it.
You see, John? You see?
It is my great ambition to demonstrate that nature is a closed system, that in any transformation, no amount of matter, no mass, is ever lost and none is gained. The people. It is they who will determine right and wrong.
Emily, you are being absurd. Why ascribe to an object a vague and immeasurable force like vis viva? It is a return to the old ways.
Are you capable of discovering something of your own?
I discovered you!
There is no right time for the truth.
Fräulein Leutner.
Yes?
Otto Hahn.
The nucleus is our focus.
The Jewess endangers our institute.
We can't harbor a Jew. If she stays, the regime will shut us all down.
He's split the atom.
No. You've split the atom.
Energy equals mass times the square of the speed of light.
Would you like me to check your mathematics?
Corporate funding for NOVA is provided by Google.
Major funding for NOVA is provided by the Howard Hughes Medical Institute, serving society through biomedical research and science education, HHMI.
Funding for Einstein's big idea is provided by the National Science Foundation, America's investment in the future. And by the Alfred P. Sloan Foundation to enhance public understanding of science and technology. And the U.S. Department of Energy, fostering science and security. Major funding for NOVA is also provided by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by PBS viewers like you. Thank you.
A 100 years ago, a deceptively simple formula revealed a hidden unity buried deep in the fabric of the universe. It tells of a fantastic connection between energy, matter, and light. Its author was a youthful Albert Einstein. It's the most famous equation in the world. E equals MC squared. But while we've all heard of Einstein's big idea, very few of us know what it means. In fact, E equals MC squared is so remarkable that even Einstein wasn't sure if it was really true.
Albert, darling,
you're later than I expected. We've only got sausage and cheese tonight. What is it?
We need to talk.
Has something happened?
Oh, no, nothing. Sorry, no. I spent most of the day staring out the window at work, looking at trains. And I started to think about an object and how much energy it had. Can I explain it to you?
Of course you can. But first, dinner. Food and talk.
I think the gods are laughing at me.
The gods were not laughing at Einstein. He'd united in one stunning insight the work of many who had come before him. Scientists who'd fought and even died to create each part of the equation. The story of E equals MC squared starts long before Einstein with the discovery of E for energy. In the early 19th century, scientists didn't think in terms of energy. They thought in terms of individual powers or forces. These were all disconnected, unrelated things. The power of the wind, the force of a door closing, the crack of lightning. The idea that there might be some sort of overarching, unifying energy which lay behind all these forces had yet to be revealed. One lowly man's drive to understand the hidden mysteries of nature would begin to change all that.
Young Michael Faraday hated his job. He was uneducated, the son of a blacksmith. He'd been lucky to become a bookbinder's apprentice. But Faraday craved one thing. He craved knowledge. He read every book that passed through his hands. He developed a passion for science. All of his free time and his meager wages were poured into his self-education. He was on the threshold of an incredible journey into the invisible world of energy.
Faraday had impressed one of his master's customers and was rewarded with a ticket that would change his life.
Excuse me, please. Can I pass, please?
Can I pass?
Some of us are trying to improve ourselves. If people will let us.
Of course, pass, pass.
This way to a better life.
In the early 1800s, science was a pursuit of gentlemen, something Faraday was clearly not. He had a rudimentary education. He'd read widely. He'd gone to public lectures. But in 1812, he was given tickets to hear Sir Humphry Davy, the most prominent chemist of the age.
Nineteenth-century scientists were the pop stars of their day. Their lectures were hugely popular. Tickets were hard to come by, and Davy reveled in his status.
They're waiting.
I know.
He was also a keen follower of the latest fashion, nitrous oxide, or laughing gas. He said it had all the benefits of alcohol without the hangover.
Electricity, ladies and gentlemen. A mysterious force that can unravel the confusing mixture of intermingled substances that surround us and produce pure elements.
Davy was an absolutely first-rate scientist. However, many will come to say that his greatest discovery is Michael Faraday.